The Gemara in Pesachim and Daf Kuf Ches Amid Aleph 108a discusses the mitzvah of on Leil Pesach, of the night of Pesach, of Haseba, the mitzvah of reclining, and specifically reclining on the left-hand side, which was the custom back then, and that was custom even today during the night of Pesach. So the Gemara tells us, on what type of foods do we have to recline on? Do we recline the whole night from Kiddush on? There are some opinions like that the whole meal you should be reclining. But the Gemara, that's not a halacha that you don't have to. The Gemara talks about specific mitzvahs of the night. So the Gemara says, matzah sarech haseba. When you're eating the matzah, you require reclining. Marar eina sricha haseba. When you eat the marar, you do not require reclining. And the comment is explained because matzah represents our freedom, our leaving of Egypt. And marar represents our slavery, our hard times in Egypt. Reclining is something of a free person, it's a sign of freedom. So when you have matzah, you recline. When you have marar, you don't. What happens if you forget to recline while eating the matzah? And we'll see as well that when we get to the four cups of wine, the Gemara also says they have to recline in the four cups of wine. We'll come to that shortly. But what about matzah? You eat the matzah without reclining. Keep on going, or you have to have another kezayis of matzah?
No.
So this seems to be a dispute between the Rush, Rabbeinu Asher, and the Rambam, and Maimonides. The Rush writes, you have to go back and have another piece of matzah. And the Rambam doesn't say it explicitly, but the way the Brisker Rav learns the Rambam, it seems to imply that you do not have to go back if you forget to recline while eating the matzah. What's in the Kudus HaMachlokes? What's the issue between the Rush and the Rambam? Why yes, why not? So the issue is, what is the relationship between the mitzvah of Haseba, the mitzvah of reclining, and the mitzvah of matzah, and for that matter, the mitzvah of drinking the four cups? So we'll speak about matzah for a minute. So according to the Rush, they're independent. Or just like the rabbis, just like the Torah told us, we have to eat matzah, how much we have to eat. The Torah is also concerned, and our rabbis are also concerned with, in the manner of which we eat it. It's a detail within the mitzvah of matzah. Eating matzah, how much, and the way are all part and parcel of the mitzvah of matzah. If you don't do it, just like if you didn't eat the appropriate shear, you have to go back. So too, if you don't recline, you have to go back. That seems to be the opinion of the Rush. And he says his Gemara, the Gemara says, a shamish, a waiter, who eats a kezayis of matzah without reclining, I think the Gemara is talking about he's standing up serving, eino yotze. He doesn't fulfill his mitzvah. And the Rush says, we see from here, you have to go back and have another piece of matzah. And the Rambam disagrees and says, Haseba isn't connected to the mitzvah of matzah per se. It's an independent mitzvah of the night. On the night of Pesach, you have a mitzvah to recline. That's why according to the Rambam and according to the Meiri, as I said, the mitzvah is to recline the whole Seder, not limited to a specific mitzvah. It's a general mitzvah to recline. And according to the Rambam, if you forget to recline, just keep on going. So recline now, because the mitzvah is now on any specific moments of the Seder. The mitzvah is to recline all the time. So as long as you recline some of the time, you get the mitzvah. What does the Rambam do with the Gemara? The shamish, the waiter, who eats a kezayis matzah, eino yotze. But if you notice, the Gemara doesn't say, what mitzvah doesn't he fulfill? The Rush learned he doesn't fulfill the mitzvah of matzah. The Rambam says, of course he fulfilled the mitzvah of matzah. It's a mitzvah of aseba. He's just lacking in his mitzvah of reclining, but it's not the mitzvah of matzah. And therefore, that's a fundamental machlokes, the Rambam and the Rush. In general, since it's a din d'oraisa of matzah, let's say one should try not to forget to recline because on the right, you know, the many who say you have to go back and eat another kezayis of matzah. So, yeah.
So,
what is leaning? In other words, do I have to lean 25 degrees, or is 15 degrees sufficient?
Right, so that's a separate discussion. How do you define leaning in terms of how far, how much to the left you have to go? Like during back in the days of the Gemara, they used to like kind of lie on a couch. But that's a fair question. But whatever, but what we're discussing here is whatever is, whatever, if it's considered leaning, you know, then you're okay. If it's not, you know, how far down you have to go. And then obviously, if you're somewhat to the left, maybe it's more than you usually do. You know, so we have different. We'll have the discussion exactly how far one has to go. But then, you know, then that was just, if you went down a little bit, then that could be a different question than if you didn't do anything. You know, how far, so Jeff is raising a good point, what's the definition of a seba? But the machlok is round rush, isn't on what the definition is. Whatever we decide it is, and you didn't do it, that's our discussion here. But Jeff is raising a good point.
Normally it's like this. So leaning would be like,
he's hopeless.
So you go out off the angle.
If we lean on the first night, and on the second night we forget to lean, do we still have to repeat on the second night?
Yeah, so the general, even though the second night's draw, but the general rule is whatever we do the first night, we have to do the second night. So if the halacha would be on the first night, you did something you have to redo, then it would apply also on the second night. But it also depends, it gets into what is the ikar matzah, is it the first matzah you eat at the meal? That's why we have different shiurim in terms of how much, like I don't know if you have they have, in the name of Ramosha, they have like this chart. You know, again, in general, how much you have to eat is a separate discussion. Many people are very machmir, which is okay if you know you're being machmir, but it's important to know what you really have to eat versus what you think you have to eat. But there's a chart in terms of for karpas or for matzah, the different. So let's say when it comes to the biblical mitzvah of matzah, so we have to eat, let's say, the whole piece. But let's say we're talking about karpas, the zeichel mikdash, the sandwich that we have by Hillel. Korach. So that's only a smaller piece. Again, you have to know if you're involved in a mitzvah midrabban, a mitzvah in a Torah, we can get into the details. But right now we're talking about more fundamentally, if you, whatever reclining means, if you don't do it, you have to go back. So according to the rush, so one should be careful unless you like eating a lot of matzah, one should be, in fact, that's a discussion what the Rambam, that's the opinion in the Rambam. Let's say, some want to say a little different than the Rambam, that let's say the case is as follows. What happens, let's say you walk in, let's say you forget to recline the first time, and you're about to recline on your second piece of matzah, and your Rebbe walks into your Seder. Why did I say your Rebbe? Because there's a Gemara in Pesachim which says it gives different times where a person isn't supposed to recline. So it's not, as you know, it's not respect to recline in front of your Rebbe, so, or your Rav. So therefore, it says, so you're not supposed to. So Shaila is, what happens if someone ate the first piece of matzah not reclining? This isn't the Gemara, this is what the Achronim asked, we showed him. And then your Rebbe walks into the room. So now what? Do I have to eat a second piece of matzah? What do I do now? I can't recline anyway now. I ate the first piece of matzah, so what should I do now? So that depends on the machlokas, the Rush and the Rambam. According to the Rush, you haven't fulfilled your mitzvah of matzah yet, because you ate your matzah without reclining. So therefore, you have to go ahead. So even though the second time you're going to eat the matzah without reclining, but that's the halacha now. The halacha is saying now, in this situation, I'm only obligated to eat the matzah without reclining. But perhaps according to the Rambam, there's no point of eating the matzah, because why? The mitzvah of matzah you already fulfilled already. What's the only reason, let's say, you'd be eating over again, would be out, assuming you have to eat over again, would be out the midst of reclining. But you're not going to recline anyway now, because your Rebbe's in the room, and there might be no point in having another piece of matzah, or let's say making a bracha. According to the Rush, perhaps you're chayav to make a bracha because you didn't fulfill your mitzvah the first time. According to the Rambam, if you already fulfilled your mitzvah of matzah, you only have to redo reclining, assuming you want to say that's the pshat in the Rambam, because it's not clear what the Rambam holds about going back to Briscoe Rebbe. Others want to say even the Rambam agrees you have to go back, But you have to go back because you're lacking in the mitzvah of reclining, not because of the mitzvah of matzah. And you can't just recline in a vacuum. You have to recline when you're eating the matzah. Yeah. So a nafka mina would be when you go back, would you have to make another bracha? Or the case that if your Rebbe walked in, you're not going to recline. It's kind of like the shy we just had Rosh Chodesh. Like last night, let's say you davened mincha and you left out Yalav v'yavo and Shemona Esrei. And now it's Mairav. So do you daven a second Shemona Esrei or not? Because what's the issue? Because mincha you already davened. But and in Mairav you can't mention Yalav v'yavo. Rosh Chodesh is over. So is there any point in davening a second Shemona Esrei? So it depends. It's a machlokes rishonim, Rabbeinu Yehuda and the Rif. According to Rabbi Yehuda, no, there's no point. You already fulfilled your mitzvah of tefillah, and you're not going to do yalav yalav anyway. So what could you do? There's no point in davening a second Shmon Esrei. And according to the Rush, of course you do. What's the issue? Because how do you view a Shmon Esrei without yalav yalav? The Rabbi Yehuda says you fulfilled your mitzvah of davening. You're just lacking in the special mitzvah of yalav yalav. So you can't do that, so you're not going to gain. But according to the Rif, you're not even yotzei your mitzvah of mincha. So therefore, it's like someone who didn't slept through mincha, you woke up, it was nighttime. Just like in that situation, you have to daven over again, so to here. So it's similar, you know, it's similar to the case of matzah in terms of how you view. If you view that you didn't fulfill the mitzvah of matzah at all, so even if you can't recline, it doesn't make a difference. You have an obligation to eat the matzah. But according to the Rambam, if it's going lacking in the mitzvah seba, one could, you know, one could debate whether one should even go back and have another piece of matzah because you're not going to recline anyway. Someone had a question? Yeah.
I think you said that the Rambam, maybe the Rambam would say that if you ate without reclining, you had matzah, then you maybe should go back anyway.
Right, according to the somewhere in the Rambam, you don't have to go back at all. Others say, no, even the Rambam agrees you have to go back, but you have to go back not because of the mitzvah of matzah, you have to go back because of the mitzvah of Haseba.
But even the Rambam would say, look, you forgot, so bad luck. Now from now on, you're lean.
That's the way the Briska Rav might. The others say, no, it is. See, the way the Briska Rav learned it, that matzah and Haseba is independent. Other people say, no, everyone agrees there's a connection between matzah and Haseba.
Even
within the Rambam. The question is, what is the connection? The question is, when I eat matzah without reclining, what did I do wrong? Is it something lacking in the matzah? Or something lacking in my mitzvah seba. That's why others explain. And therefore, if you hold it's lacking in mitzvah, that's the Rosh Hashitah. And therefore, you have to make a new bracha because you didn't fulfill your mitzvah matzah. I would have to even eat another piece of matzah even if the Rebbe walked in the room. But according to the Rambam, if I'm lacking in my mitzvah seba, I do have to eat it over again normally, in a case where my Rebbe is going to be in the room again, so maybe then one could argue there's no point in eating another piece of matzah because I'm not going to gain the reclining because I'm not going to recline. According to the Briska Rav, he's saying it's like the first way we say, like you're saying, that's true. Just keep. But others want to say, no, that even according to Rambam, there is a connection, but everyone agrees, even according to the Rambam, it's different than the Rush. The Rush holds it's lacking, the Achilas Matzah is lacking, while according to the Rush, according to the Rambam, it's that Seba is lacking, and it's kind of like you can't do Haseba in a vacuum. Haseba has to be done in...
Okay, I got it.
But you give more Hashiva to the Matzah by doing Haseba, but if you're not going to be able to recline anyway, what's the point of eating? That's the question over there. So what about the drinking of the wine? So by matzah, it's clear. The Gemara says, what does it say by Dalet Kosa? So the Gemara quotes in the name of Rav Nachman, you have to recline, so everything's clear. Not so simple. But we have four cups of wine. So what do we how many of the four cups, 1 to 4, how many do we have to recline for? Well, we have the four cups of wine. So the two students saying two different things, sounds familiar, in the name of Rav Nachman, in the name of the Rebbe. One claim Rav Nachman said, you have to recline. Everyone claims Rav Nachman said you only have to recline on 2 out of the 4 cups. The debate among the students, obviously one of them fell asleep in the middle, and only heard a little knowledge is dangerous, as they say. One claimed he said the first 2 cups you have to recline, and the other one claimed the last 2 cups he has to recline. So that's it, and they both have different. They both give reasons why they think the first 2 yes, the last 2 not. And the other one gives reasons why the last 2 yes, the first 2 not. The Gemara goes to the discussion. Everyone agrees wine needs reclining. The question is which cups, And the Gemara concludes, since we're not sure, Aidi va'aidi by Haseba. Since we're not sure, the Gemara concludes, we have to recline on all four cups. So the bottom line of the Gemara is, we'll have to discuss more of the lumdus behind it, the famous question of the Ran, but the Gemara's conclusion is, on all four cups of wine, we have to recline. Just to give you the halacha maisa before we go back into the lumdus is, so what do we do then, let's say, in terms of, so the matzah we do go back, what about the wine? So the halacha maisa is the first two cups, if you forget to recline, you go back and you have to drink them over. The last two cups, you don't have to go back. What's the difference between the first two? It's not a fundamental difference, it's a pragmatic difference, because the halacha is...
A lot of wine.
Yeah, but that's a different pragmatic difference. that's just have in mind not to recline, but the difference is, during the first two cups, strictly speaking, you made kiddush, you're allowed to drink. And you're allowed to eat during. Al Minig is not to eat until we get to the Netila Shadayim, until we get to the meal. But strictly speaking, one could drink wine during the Haggadah, meaning the first part of the Seder. Al Minig is not to. So the Bori Prayer Guffin covers you on the whole first part of the Seder. So even if I forgot to drink, if I forgot to recline, I'm allowed to drink. So they say go back and drink another cup of wine with reclining now. But when you get to the third and fourth cup, we're not allowed to eat anything more. We want to leave the tam of the matzah, the taste of the matzah in our mouth. So there's a halachic issue now of let's say I don't have to drink more wine, and I'm doing something I'm not allowed. So that's a suffix. So therefore, that's what the post comes in. Not because we're paskening like one of the students of Rav Nachman over the other. It's a pragmatic concern that for the first two cups, I'm allowed to drink more. So therefore, okay, so big deal. So not big deal, but to have another cup and recline. But for the last two cups, since anyway it's usher to eat after the afikomen, and it's a shaila, do I have to go back and recline or not? So therefore, it's a suffolk and violate doing something wrong. So then we when in doubt, do without suffolk. You know, suffolk lakula. So that's the bottom line. But so that's the conclusion. But the question is the famous kasha of the Ran. Why does the Gemara say we have to recline on all four? Because we know we have a famous principle we've discussed many times and probably will continue many more times. Safik d'oraisa l'chumra, a doubt regarding a biblical law was strict on. Safik d'rabanan l'kula, a doubt on a rabbinic law was lenient. Yeah.
So isn't there something similar in terms of whether we're supposed to drink four cups? That if you only drank the first two or you only drank the last two and you weren't sure, you'd end up not drinking anything at all?
Yes, that's you already gave me one of the answers in Iran.
Right, that's why I thought it sounds all very similar.
Right, the terms of the mitzvah of Dalet Kosos, that's a mitzvah midrabanan. The Gemara talks about three things, even though there are mitzvahs asei shazman grama, even though they're time-oriented mitzvahs women are obligated in, Mitzvahs Drabbanan of Nir Chanukah, Kriyas HaMegillah, and Dalet Kosos. So Dalet Kosos is Drabbanan. So the question is, why did the Gemara conclude L'chumra? In other words, they should have said, okay, so I'm not sure, so recline on two out of the four. Or, you know, we'll see, whatever conclusion I want to come to, but it shouldn't have been ID the ID by Haseba. So that's a famous kasha of the Ran. Why does the Gemara conclude you have to recline on all four? It should have concluded at least something else, maybe recline on two or some other conclusion. So the Ran himself gives two answers. The Ran himself says you're right. Really, it should be suffik derabanan lakula. Really, we do say, strictly speaking, if you drink the wine without reclining, you are yotze, because suffik derabanan lakula. But on something which doesn't take a lot of effort, like moving a little bit to the left and reclining while you drink the wine, so therefore the Gemara says you might as well do it. The Ran says it specifically by Dalet Kosos. The Mishnah Brewer and other posts can extend it to all cases of Suffolk Drabbanan, and that it's true, strictly speaking, even though a doubt on the rabbinic level you could be lenient, but if it's not a big deal to be strict, it's a milsa which doesn't involve a tircha. And therefore, that's what happened. But according to that, you're right. Really, you didn't. Even if you didn't, if you recline, if you drank the wine without reclining, you would be. Well, get the second answer in the round is much more fundamental. There are five different answers in the round, Kasha. We'll have to continue.